I wasn't successful in getting my kids interested in science. And maybe it's a kind of a field that, the only thing is that they got to discover it for themselves. I mean, the ones that need to discover it will do it, and the others may not. Although there are plenty of people who have, scientists who have managed to train their, bring their kids up with a similar interest in fact, even in the same specific field. And look at Dan Koshland, who just died. He's got a highly qualified son who's also a biochemist, Dan, and Doug is his son's name. Interesting homograph, by the way, D.E. Koshland. One's Dan, one's Douglas. But his son only uses a D to differentiate himself, where his father always said D.E. And you know, that clearly had nothing to do with money or anything. That was just curiosity. He was basically a very wealthy, was born into a very wealthy family there. Levi Strauss, I think, was there. And his, so wealth, of course, science used to be the interest of the upper class. You know, think of all the scientists who came from the upper middle class and even the ruling class in England and elsewhere. And it's rather interesting that the early days that some of you couldn't afford to be a scientist if you were poor. So that's kind of an interesting part of the history of science in the 17th, 18th century. Although I don't know that somebody like Benjamin Franklin wasn't wealthy, clearly. How did he manage to make that transition from being apprentice to becoming a founder of the American Philosophical Society.